An out-of-this-world discovery is made right here in Texas, and it's finding a new home in Fort Worth.
Joel Thomas live at TCU for us tonight to explain how the largest meteorite ever uncovered in our state was found.
Yeah, and it is a big one. This one right here says one of the largest found in Texas, 250 pounds. Well, the new one is almost three times this size. And look, you can see these meteorites have a distinctive color. That's the first thing a dude ranch owner north of Amarillo noticed. The second thing was the rock made his horse behave strangely.
I mean, I've seen a lot of rocks, but nothing like that. So I go and try to get up close to it with my horse. You know, I walk up there to it, and he gets about 10 feet from it and stops and snorts at it, you know, and backs up. And I try to get him up there, and he just snorts.
Frank Hommel and his horse had discovered the second largest meteorite of its kind found in America. But why did his horse have such an adverse reaction to it?
I don't know. Isn't that weird?
What the gallery curators do know is this 760-pound meteorite is ending a journey that began before the Earth was formed.
This is the building blocks. This is before all that happened. This is what the Earth would have looked like before it melted.
Its enormous size dwarfs other meteorites, which makes it very rare.
You know, I've been doing this over 18 years, and I've never come across something like this. So it, in the respect of size, it may not ever happen again for me.
The Hommels had several other offers to buy the meteorite, but there was one big factor that finally landed it at TCU.
And we talked about it, and we really felt like we'd like it for it to stay in Texas. It was found in Texas, so.
Now, the gallery will only say it paid fair value for the meteorite, which online runs about $20 a gram. There would be 344,000 grams plus in that one meteorite, so do the math. And they are working now to build a display so you can visit it right here on TCU's campus. Reporting live, Joel Thomas, CBS 11 News.